First of all, guys, this is my part number two. I'm really very sorry because in my part number one, I have not taken all this value in a proper one manner. So that's why I make the two separate part, part one and part two. Okay, so let's continue my part number one in this part number two. Okay, so we are up, we just in part number one, we calculate TDN and TDJ and TDN. Okay, so first let me tell you the table number. The table number five, okay, table number 5 from IS code 30 page number. Okay, IS code page number 30, there is a clause 5.4.1. From this clause, you can calculate the gamma, you can take the value of gamma MO, gamma M1 and gamma MO for buckling and yielding value, for buckling and yielding. Okay, I just show you, if you can see, okay, you can see there, okay. This is value. Okay, sorry, my camera is not proper, but here is a table number, and from this table you can just take it out the all the value of the gamma M1 and gamma MO for yielding and buckling. Okay, and now from we can just go. I just show the section number 6.2, 6.8. You can just see it. This is what the this is the clause for the design of compression tension member. Okay, here is what the TDG formula. Okay, you can simply see this. This is what the TDG formula. This is what TDN formula for a plate. But we are not going to design. We are not going to solve the plate over there. We are just going to solve for the solve for the voltage value. Okay, so for volt we are using this value, this table, this this formula you can see there. So it is what the beta value also given to you. All formula is given in our page number 33 of the IS 800-2007. And here the approximate formula, which is I told you the alpha formula, and here all the values listed, like the 0.7 for the 3 volt what we are taking in the last part number 1, 0.8 for the weighted connection or for more than 4 volt. Okay, so now we are going to determine the design strain due to the blocks here. So this is TDG is nothing but design strain and strain due to blocks here. The value, the formula is also given to you all here. Okay, you can see this. It is very very properly listed in the IS code, IS code 800-2007. Okay, so now on this page number 33, and the notification of the ABG, ABN, ADG, ATN is given on the page number 34, at the view before the above the clause number 6.4.2. Okay, and 6.4.2 clause is given to you all for the welded connection. Okay, so now, just write it down. Okay, just clear the all the value where for it's come from. I just wanted to make this video very long because of the all there's lots of detail values given to you. Okay, so now we are going to determine the this TDB. It is TDB is nothing but for a voltage connection is given for the design strain due to block shear. Okay, so design strain due to block shear, there's a two formula, which is first this formula. So in this formula, we apply gamma under 3 and gamma m is not, we have to calculate, these all are given to you. Only the values ABG and ATN for a voltage connection we have to determine. Okay, so determination of the ABG and ATN value calculation is like this. So determination of the ABG value. Okay, the ABG value, when we are going to determine the formula for the ABG value is like this. LVG multiplied by T. So what exactly LVG? LVG is nothing but the total distance, that means the edge distance, that is this distance, edge from first edge distance to the last pitch distance. Okay, so this distance is called as the LVG. That means edge plus pitch distance, this total distance is called as the this total distance is called as what LVG. Now as I solve this all the value, I take it down, the pitch value is as a 80 mm. Okay, which is given to us, or okay, I take age value from my calculation is 40 mm, I assume this value, or you can take you can solve that from the formula, and G value take it as a 60 mm. Okay, so the formula calculates like 40 plus 80 plus 80. Okay, so it is 80 plus 80, 160 plus 40 is 200. So that is the LVG equals to 200 multiplied by T is thickness. Thickness is our 8. Okay, so multiply by 8, so we got 1600 mm square. Okay, mm square, that means it is in mm, it is in mm, so it is mm square. So we got the value of ABG. Okay, when we go, when we are going to solve the value for the ATG, okay, so the calculation of the ATG is in such a manner that the formula is LTG multiplied by thickness. Okay, so LTG, when we are going to calculate, it is in such a manner that the LTG is very simple, that this total value, that means LTG is this value. Okay, so that means this is the L1, so L1 minus of G is called as LTG. Okay, so LTG is nothing but LTG is not, I can write down here L1 minus of G multiplied by T. Okay, so you get the value which is called as, that is the G is a 60 and our L1 is 100. So 100 minus 60 is 40. So our calculation is like 40 multiplied by 8. This 40 is come from 100 minus of 60. Okay, so from this value we get 40. So our 320 mm square. Okay, so this is what exactly the value we got for the AVG and ATG. Okay, so we are going to place the all the value over here. So formula, so we have just placed this all the value. So it is 1600 multiplied by Fy, value is 250 divided by under this 50 under root by 3 multiplied by gamma MO is 1.1 plus 0.9 into ATG value is 320 multiplied by the value of FU is 410 divided by gamma M1 value is 1.25. So when we saw, we got the value of ATDB is as a 276.67 into 10 raised to power 3 Newton. Okay, so this value we got for a TDG. It is really very simple. You have to just write down all the formula, and with respect to the, all the formula, I can simply calculate. AVG and ATN calculation is not so much of difficult. This is only the addition of some H-distance and P-distance, and the ATG is nothing but the minus of the total length, minus of the gusset distance from the total length of the one side of the member, which is connected to the gusset plate. Okay, so then we are go for the, this is for TDB1 we calculate. Okay. This term we calculated earlier, we are not listed it as a TDB or TDB. I just categorized as a TDB1 and TDB2. In IS code, it is not classified as a TDB1 and TDB2. You have to just take it as A first as a TDB1 and also second is as a TDB2. Okay, so here we are, I just rub it down first because there is something. Just we have to remember this value. My board is not so much long, so I just take the rub it. I just have to rub it first. Okay, and then go for the next value. Okay, so here just go for the next calculation. So it is TDB of second number. Okay, this is what second number we are going to calculate, which is the formula given in the IS code. So formula is like this: 0.9 multiplied by AVN multiplied by FU under root of 3 into gamma M1. Okay, gamma M1 plus ATG multiplied by FY divided by gamma MO. So here AVM, like in for the first we have to determine AVG and ATG. Okay, I just rub it. Okay, you just write down all this value. Okay, now I just calculate the value of the AVM and ATG. Okay, so AVG value, AVN value we are going to calculate. So AVN is calculated in such a manner that the formula is, I have the formula. With the simple of this, you can just simply calculate it. Okay, so first of all, AVN is nothing but LVG, LVG minus number of bolt, okay, minus 0.5 into DN, bolt term multiplied by thickness. So this is what a formula for AVN. Okay, you have to just write down in your book. So formula is like LVG minus number of bolt minus 0.5 into DN and whole term divided by T. Okay, so this formula, when you put the all the value, so we get the value like for AVN is like 200 minus 3 bolt we are going to use minus 0.5, we have to minus from it. Okay, into DN is, we take it as a solve at 24 multiplied by thickness is as a 8. Okay, so whatever the AVN value we got, it as is a 1120 mm square. Okay, so for next value ATG, it is in a such a, it can be solved in a such a way that the formula is to be there is a LTG minus 0.5 DN. Okay, LTG minus 0.5 into DN into thickness. Okay, so when we put all the value, what is the value of LTG? is 40 minus 0.5 into 24 multiplied by 8. So the value we got is 224 m square. Okay, so these two values we have to put in your this formula. So the calculation is like PDB equals to 0.9 into AVF, the value is 1120 multiplied by FU is this is very very long, like a long numerical, is a 410 divided by under root 3 into 1.25 plus the value is 320 multiplied by 250 divided by 1.1. So we get the value it as a 263.61 into 10 to the power 3 Newton. Okay, so this is what the another value we got for the TdV. So from these two, the first TdV value is we got is 276.67 into 10 to the power 3. So the least value from this is 263. So we take the value of the TdV as 263.61. Okay, so now I just rub it down first. Okay, so now we got the three value according to the IS code. What they listed TdV, TdN and TdB. Okay, so from that the least value, the minimum value, that was the first I write the TdG value. TdG value is 349.77 into 10 to the power 3, which is we calculated in our part number 1, which is Newton. Okay, then TdN value which we got is 309.27 into 10 to the power 3 Newton, and TdB value which is take the least value from both TdB is 263.61 into 10 to the power 3 Newton. Okay, so from this three value, the least value is this. Okay, 263.61. So our TD is nothing but TD equals to 263.61 into 10 to the power 3 Newton. Okay, so this is what our inside least value of the TD. Okay, so the after that. Okay, so up to this point you got the value of the TD, and then you can further go for your calculation. So hope you like my video properly. Now guys, I just wanted to clear something also. Actually in this video we have just taken out the one single angle section. In this case, in the different case, like the this angle section maybe it given in a different manner, like the this is what type number 2, but I wanted to clarify the type number 2 and type number 3 in this video also. Okay, so in the case that this is gusset plate, okay, this is a gusset plate, okay, and this gusset plate, the one single angle is connected over here, okay, and they told you that the one also single angle is connected, that means two single angle connected by opposite side of the gusset plate or either side of the gusset plate, then it will be done in such a manner. Okay, let me draw it properly. Okay, I'll just clear you all the concepts. Okay, so if such a manner of the calculus, that what exactly when these conditions come, when they told you like that the two angle section plus back to back on the opposite side of the gusset plate, then and only then this type of the conditions coming over there. So during calculation of the TD, it is not so much of hard, whatever the edge you calculate, okay, you have to make one thing, that you have to multiply that area by 2. Okay, so similarly in each thing, whatever you are calculating, you have to multiply by 2. Okay, so like that, first of all you have to determine the TdG, okay, TdB, TdG. So for that, whatever the AG is required, which is already is not AG, it is a AG equals to twice of the gross area, twice of the area of the particular one section. Okay, similar, whatever you did for this section, same thing you have to do for this angle section also. Okay. Okay, same thing you have to do for this angle section. This is what bolted connection. assign over there. Okay, so I'll take one numerical on this, which is very very simple. But instead of my college's timing, I'm not able to give all brief regarding in such a manner. Okay, I just give you in a PDF format. I just explain you on a PDF. Okay, you have to just clarify your concept, and I'm damn sure that I'm liable to clear your concept in proper manner. So hope you like my video. Please give a thumbs to my video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, and have a nice day. Bye bye.